The date was 1st of June 1830. The farmer observed that in his field there was a fire the last night and his barn and haystack turned into ashes. Generally, laborer used to come and destroy the machines, the threshing machines, and sometimes they used to burn the entire farmhouses and they used to go away. They used to get like this number of cases in the coming months. The rich people were shocked. Why are the laborer coming and destroying the threshing machines? It was on 28th of August 1830 in the region of East Kent. Many of the machines were destroyed by the laborers. 387 machines were destroyed by the laborers, threshing machines, in the next 2 years. And the rich people, those who own a machine, used to get warning letters on the name of Captain Swing. Captain Swing had a brand in England. Actually, we don't have any person called Captain Swing. It is a mythical name or a mythic name, which is just an imaginary name written on the letters to warn the people. People, laborers used to roam as bands at night time, come and destroy the machines and burn the farmhouses, and they used to go away. The people were suspicious, and as they are getting warning letters at night, they have the people roaming in the villages, in the towns, and destroying the machines. The rich people themselves, those who own the machines, started to destroy the machines because they are scared of what is going to happen. The government was very serious on this. Government arrested nearly 1976 people. In this, 9 were hanged and the rest, 505, were sent out of the country, means transported, and then 450 were sent to Australia, 644 were sent behind the bars, were imprisoned. So government has taken a firm step. What is the reason? Why did the laborers react like this? For what are they fighting for? Why are they against the machines, especially the threshing machines? What happened to them? Why are they hating the machines so much? In order to find the answer for these questions, we need to look at the lesson. The lesson name is The Peasants and the Farmers. In this unit, we'll be discussing how the peasants and the farmers reacted to the modern form of agriculture, how it has brought the day-to-day changes. In this, we will deal, and now we will come to know the answers for the questions what we have saw till now. Now, open fields and commons. Now, moving on into the details, why did the laborers react in such a manner so harsh and destroyed the entire machinery? For that, we need to go into the details of the history to understand that. First, before 19th century, England is having open field system along the countryside where there is no private allotment or blocking of the lands or no partitions which enrolled the private individuals to have their own lands. It's a common distribution. And every year they have a meeting in which all the farmers are allotted a certain strips of cropping. These strips also, they used to maintain one strip and the other strip very far away from each other so that they get the combination of good and the bad soil fertility. It's not necessary that all the strips are next to each other. So they used to get differently in different corners, and everybody used to have a common share here. Everybody used to work here and they used to pasture their cows, graze their sheep. They used to collect the fuel wood for fire. They used to collect the berries, fruits for food. They used to do fishing in the nearby rivers and ponds. They used to hunt the rabbits. Like this, they used to do many occupations, though their income is merely very less. But still, they used to have fields. Along with that, they used to have their sheep, goat, or their cattle, or the fishing, the other incomes also to help them to tide over the bad situations or the bad climatic conditions. But these all did not do much favor or did not bring great change in the lives of the farmers. Now, By the 16th century itself, some fields started to get enclosed. It's not only, they did not wait up to the 19th century. In some parts of the country, it started to get enclosed by 16th century. What is the basic reason for them to enclose the fields? The basic reason was the price of the wool has shot up in the 16th century. So now the rich farmers and the landlords want to increase their sheep production so that the wool they can earn more profits. So they want to have a common land where they can breed their sheep. So now they don't want anyone to share their lands. So they decided to enclose the lands which earlier was common to all. And in this process, the rich farmers want to expand their territories so that they can have farms and sheep rearing happening on large scale. So they enclosed the common lands. Those who are is there in the middle class or the poor people are staying in that. These people, those who have small cottages and all, these people were thrown out of their houses and that were occupied, and the poor were not allowed into the regions where they have enclosed them. So like this, they started to enclose the common lands into their private lands. Later, the individual landlords mainly did these all kind of activities. It was around from 1750 to 1850, nearly 6 million hectares of land was enclosed like this. It's not only enclosing of this, and the government did not do anything from the far. Government also played an active role in this. Government made 4,000 acts to ensure the legalizing of these enclosements. So now, the acts which are done by the rich landlords were getting support by the government. And these acts were made to enable that what they have done is right. And they have changed the properties into the names of the rich landlords and made it sure that these all are legal things. So there is no kind of occupying some land or forcing somebody to send outside. Like this, government also started to give support to the rich landlords and started to deny the poor man's side.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.